1956. And would you believe, each time I go for a conference, I get more confused. And I have not understood either of them till today. Now, I don't belong to any system. A lot of people say allopathy. All systems are allopathy except homeopathy. Allopathy, against disease. So, even Ayurveda is allopathy. But because of this one sentence, the Punjab High Court judgment said you can't teach Ayurveda to modern medicine because one is allopathy, one is Ayurveda. So, they're all except homeopathy all around. Now, the problem about Western medicine, which we call as modern medicine, because we think modern has to come from West. No, it's a mistake. Modernity comes from our antiquity. West also had their modernity from their antiquity. So, but most of us are RNA, resident non-Indian. So, we think with the mind in America or England and then live here, unfortunately. Resident non-Indian. That's why we think whatever comes from the West is modern. You saw so many studies now. I give you only one study. Mr. Pitt's study. How many of you heard of Mr. Pitt's study? Multiple risk factor intervention trial, which was studied for 25 long years. No study has done that. All studies maximum 1 year, 5 years, 6 years, etc. The MR Pitt study showed which screened 500,000 Americans to choose 100,000 Americans for the study. Imagine the magnitude of the study. And it spent over $110 million. At the end, it showed, I'll just give you the last sentence. Risk factor, there is nothing called risk factor in the multiple risk factors intervention trial. Even if there is anything called risk factor and you change it, the risk if there is not changed. The study has been a boondoggle. You know what is meant by boondoggle? Waste of money. Now we say we must have controlled studies, Western studies, even our friend Nagendra sold to me that thought. Controlled studies, randomized controlled studies. The president of NICE, Michael Rawlins, giving a talk at the Royal College in London in 2008 and then published in the Royal College Journal, said the RCTs unfortunately are given a very high pedestal which they don't deserve. Now there's a very nice article in Nature 3 months ago which says RCTs are no meaning. What we should have in future is N per one study. You know what that means? One patient study. Pull that together. And that's called N per one, number per one. Not 100,000, 50,000, 18,000, etc., etc. N per one. And pull that together. Now, our friend was very nicely showing how the liver is big in Indians. You would be surprised. There's a book, Diabetes is a Disease of the Liver, written 50 years ago by an American. Diabetes is a disease of the liver, not the pancreas. And that's exactly what he has shown now. Everybody's liver is big. And today, everybody's liver is big. Because we take so many medicines. If you have a headache, one paracetamol. If you have a lactate, another paracetamol. Do you know something happened recently? Parsis keep their dead bodies on the top for the vultures to eat. Now, a lot of vultures have died in Bombay. And they dissected the vultures and found paracetamol in very heavy doses in those vultures. Because old people, they always take painkillers. This is the problem with us. So we go by these short shots, what are called reductionist studies. This word is not reductionist. The idea of the word being reductionist came from Newton and Einstein. What's called the time phase conundrum. Where they said, speed of light is the fastest and this is all that you can do. And what is science? Lot of things are talked about science. I'll give you some definition of science. Marie Curie said, science is measurement, and measurement is science. Right? Do you love your boyfriend? You do. Love is unscientific because it can't be measured. You don't love yourself. Okay.